Now let's talk about ways in which you can iteratively modify a binary image to extract some information from it. For example, let's say you have the binary image of a human body, and you want to extract the skeleton of the body. So what you'd like to do is to take this binary image and thin it down so you come down to its skeleton. The skeleton could be useful in terms of figuring out what the pose of the body is, for instance. But when you're doing this, you want to make sure that you don't change the overall structure, the integrity of the binary image. You're not introducing new objects or taking away objects. So talking about structure, a very important concept is the Euler number. The Euler number is a number of bodies minus the number of holes. So if you're looking at the letter B here in this image, the Euler number is number of bodies, which is 1, minus the number of holes, which is 2, then that's minus 1. Letter I, it's going to be 2, because it has 2 bodies and no holes. N is 1, and the Euler number of the complete image is 4. So it turns out that an interesting property is that if you take a binary image and you divide it up into non-overlapping regions, and you compute the Euler number of each region, then the Euler number of the full image is the sum of the Euler numbers of the non-overlapping regions. This is important. What this says is that if you can apply an operation to one region, to each region, which does not change the Euler number, then at the end of the day, the Euler number of the complete image remains the same. So we're particularly interested in these conservative numbers, but the Euler number doesn't change. So that brings us to the notion of Euler differential. So let's define the Euler differential E star. Imagine that you have a pixel here and it's 6 neighbors. We're going to use the hexagonal grid to represent this. So you have it 6 neighbors. If you change the center pixel from a 0 to 1, you see that the Euler number goes from a 0 to a 1. So the Euler differential is 1 minus 0, which is 1. So we can now take a look at all possible neighborhoods. And how many neighborhoods are there? So there's 64 possible neighborhoods, patterns of ones and zeros. And these neighborhood patterns can be classified based on the Euler differential they generate when the center pixel goes from a 0 to 1. And whatever that Euler differential is, it would be the negative of that when you go from a 1 to a 0. So we'll just look at going from 0 to 1. Let's take a look at an example here. Say you have the same pattern we showed before. If you take the center pixel from, change it from a 0 to 1, you get an Euler differential of 1, and that belongs to the neighborhood class n plus 1. Here's another one that belongs to the neighborhood class n plus 1. We change this from a 0 to 1. And then you have the neighborhood class n0, Euler differential 0, very important class because these are conservative operators. In this case, when you change from a 0 to 1, it doesn't introduce any new bodies or holes. Safe thing to do. And here is a case where the Euler differential is minus 1. When you introduce a 1 here, it connects this body with this body, and therefore the number of bodies goes down by 1. So an Euler differential minus 1, neighborhood class n minus 1. And then there's a neighborhood class n minus 2 in this particular case. So it turns out that there are only 4 possible neighborhood types, n plus 1, n0, n minus 1, n minus 2. So with this in place, this idea of Euler differential, you can imagine that you can now apply local operations to a binary image. And based on the neighborhood of a pixel, you can decide what kind of an operation you want to apply to it. If you want to be safe, you would use an operation that only is applicable to N0 class of neighborhoods. And then you can do this in parallel to all the points in the image. And in fact, the output that you get, you can then take that in as an input again and reapply the algorithm to that image and you get an output. So you can iteratively modify the image. The one thing that I should mention here is that when you're doing this in parallel, you want to make sure that when you're modifying a pixel, that pixel is not being used as a neighbor for any other pixel. So the way you do this is that you take the binary image and divide it up into multiple fields, often three fields are enough, apply parallel processing to all the pixels in a field, then go to the next field and the next field, and you're done. And then you can iterate on that. So let's see what we can do with this. We're particularly interested in conservative operators. So here's a notation for iterative modification. We specify a neighborhood set that we want to act on. So this could be n1, n0, n-1, n-2, or any combination of these. We'll just call it the set S. So consider pixel ij, and let aij is equal to 1 if the neighborhood of ij belongs to S. Else, it's 0. And let bij be the current value of the pixel ij. And based on these two, you're going to now assign a new value, cij, to the pixel ij. So this is how you lay it out. You have aij, bij, could be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And then corresponding to each one of these, you're going to assign an output cij. So there are four possible outputs here. These are binary numbers, obviously. And so how many ways can you fill these four slots with zeros and ones? Well, it's 2 to the power of 4, which is 16. And each one of these is an algorithm. So here are all the algorithms that you could come up with for iterative modification. Let's take a look at a couple of these. Now, some of these are just not very interesting because they do things to the image which almost look like special effects. They might create waves and stuff, but it's not really useful in the context of computer vision. But take a look at these two, for instance. Here, let's assume that the set we are interested in, neighborhood set we're interested in, is N0, which is Euler differential 0, as discussed earlier. Meaning we want to be conservative. We don't want to introduce any new objects or take away any objects. Safe operations. And if you look at algorithm number 7, you see here that when it belongs to the set, you look at the third row here, when it belongs to the set, that is aij is equal to 1, and the pixel happens to be a 0, you're going to change it to a 1. Otherwise, you're going to leave it the same, but you're going to change it to a 1. You see that? So what that means is that whenever you can, you're going to change a 0 to a 1, which means you're going to grow the object. Conversely, here you have algorithm number 4, where if you belong to the set, and let's say it's the set N0, and you happen to be a 1, then you're going to change it to a 0 right here, which means whenever you can, if a pixel is a 1, whenever it's safe to do so, you're going to make it a 0, which means you're going to thin the object. So that's growing and thinning. So let's take a look at thinning. Thinning without changing the Euler number, that is the N0 set right here, and algorithm 4. Start with a butterfly, and after one iteration you get that. You keep repeating it, and you end up getting this. Why is this useful? Imagine that you had a butterfly, an image of a butterfly, and an image of a bat, say for instance, with its wings. And you want to know which one is a bat and which one is a butterfly, it would be easier to extract the skeleton and look at the structure to say which one is which. Here you have a human body, and you apply the thinning algorithm iteratively, and you end up with the skeleton.